This week on The Adventurer, we feature an entrepreneur who saw a gap in the hair industry and made a 50 million business.
My name is Georgina Njeri Kirunga. I am 25 years old. Welcome to Nyale Creative. So I started Nyale Creative in 2012, about 4 years ago. It started as a small idea. My main purpose at the time was really to find a way to conveniently and consistently provide very high quality hair extensions to a niche market. We started selling from the boot of a car. We did online deliveries, and our first space was in Ngara.
From selling hair extensions from the trunk of her car to a 4x3 meter store in Ngara, then on to chain stores across Nairobi, Georgina's success story is an interesting one, especially with the availability of hair products in every nook and corner.
From the beginning, we've always focused on women that understand very premium hair. After being in the business more and understanding the business more, understanding the quality of my product more, I can confidently say now that I do have a specific client, and my client is a connoisseur of hair extension.
Georgina says she imports her products from South America, India, Morocco, and now also sourcing for suppliers in Malaysia and Europe. Georgina's products range from 8,000 shillings to 250,000 shillings.
I was looking at women who wear virgin human hair, which is a specific type of hair, very different to synthetic hair. It's more flexible, so you can do more to it. You can bleach it, you can dye it, you can style it, and you can use it for up to 5 years, if not longer, depending on maintenance. My client fully understands the quality of the hair that we provide, and they understand the reasoning behind the pricing, behind the purpose of the stores that we have, and why we create an experience. Because as a connoisseur, when you're buying hair extensions, it's not an immediate or impulsive purchase. Yeah, you need time to really feel the texture, feel the volume of the hair, depending on what look you're going for. The hair is first collected in its raw form. So in areas like Chennai in India, it's actually done as a religious procedure. So there are a lot of women who actually give away their hair at temples. This hair is then collected by people that source that hair. And the hair is then now sent over to London, where at our head offices, we hygienically process the hair first, and we sell the hair in different forms after that. So you get raw hair, which doesn't have a weft, and that's just for microbonding. So that will just be hygienically processed and then cut into the different lengths. You then have people that do weaving, like me. So we then add a weft, and we have special wefts. We do double wefts, which are stronger, more durable. That because the hair lasts for so long, you need a weft that can also last just as long.
Just like any other business, Georgina also faces challenges, but competition, she says, isn't one of them.
With luxury brands, as I worked with LVMH, and I got a good understanding of the loyalty of brands like Chanel and Christian Dior, is that with a luxury brand, you have your loyal customers, and your customers are loyal because they have a specific need for your product. So we focus on our market. And our market, again, they're very picky. They're very, as I said, they were connoisseurs, so they know what they're buying. So we don't fear so much about imitations or counterfeit products, or it doesn't come as a challenge, because we focus on our clients. And starting up, one of the major challenges was with information, for me personally, as I'd never done a business before. Information in terms of exactly what is required to operate fully legally. A recent challenge for me is, one is keeping up with demand. I think demand has really skyrocketed, especially in 2016. It's overwhelming. Growth is my new challenge, in terms of ensuring that as I'm growing consistently, in terms of my customer service, in terms of the experience that you're getting in the shops, and of course also in terms of the quality of my product.
Just before leaving for her next appointment, Georgina tells us about her new products.
We've opened the Lash and Brow, which is a parlor that focuses on professional eyebrow and eyelash services. And these parlors are in each of our stores.
Women opt for weaves for various reasons, and this is why Georgina and her team ensure they meet their clients' demands by offering diverse products. I am Ashley Mazuri, and this is The Adventurer.